وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to resume the series that we started. يا بني أقم الصلاة. My daughter, my son, my brother, my sister, my auntie, my nephew. أقم الصلاة. Establish the prayer. Today, inshallah ta'ala's episode, I want to talk about قوله تعالى, the statement of Allah, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. This is a أمر إلهي كريم وتوجيه رباني عظيم. This is a command from Allah تبارك وتعالى. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ. So it's an أمر إلهي. It's a godly command. It's a توجيه رباني عظيم. It's Allah directing us, سبحانه وتعالى, in the right way. Majority of us, my beloved brothers and sisters, when it comes to this command, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ, we are مُفَرِّطٌ وَلَهُ مُضَيِّعٌ. We have forsaken this command. And this is the statement of Allah تبارك وتعالى. يعني في أواخر سورة طه, Allah says, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. This is a command from Allah تبارك وتعالى في النبي الله محمد لنبيه ومصطفى محمد بن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. Allah is commanding him, وَأْمُرْ مُحَمَّدْ, command your family. And the qa'ida is, وَمَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَى بِهِ نَبِيَّهُ فَهُوَ أَمْرٌ لِأُمَّتِهِ مَا لَمْ يَكُمْ دَلِيلٌ عَلَى تَخْصِيصِ ذَلِكَ. If Allah commands the Prophet to do something, then that command is not restricted to the Prophet. It's also applying to the Ummah in general, as long as there's not an evidence that specifies the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And what we know from this verse is, وَلَا مُخَصِّصَ لَهَا, it has no evidence that specifies it to the Prophet. لِهَذَا بِاتِّفَاقِ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ, this is, يعني, by consensus of the scholars, is that if something is not restricted to the Prophet and it's applying to everybody, فَوَجَبَ عَلَى كُلِّ أَبٍ وَكُلِّ وَلِيٍ وَكُلُّ وَلِيِّ أَمْرٍ أَنْ يُعْنَى بِأَبْنَائِهِ عِنَايَةً عَظِيمَةً. Every father, every mother, every leader, everybody in charge, it refers to them. That they give consideration to their children, their family members, regarding what? Making sure that they pray the salah when they reach the age of praying. And that the father and the mother, they follow up the child, mutaba'atan daqiqatan fi sha'ni salah. They follow the child to the T, as they say. Why? Because it is أعظم أركان الإسلام بعد شهادتين. The salah is the greatest pillars after the two testimonies. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. The greatest thing is what? It is the salah. Let's take some benefits from this verse. This ayah al-kareema دلت على مقامين عظيمين لا بد من تحقيقهما. This verse, وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك والعاقبة للتقوى. This ayah has shown two great stations that must be there. الأول, عناية المرء, the importance that a person, يعني عناية المرء نفسه بالمحافظة على الصلاة والاصطبار على أدائها. The importance that a person should give to safeguarding the prayer and being patient upon it. Okay? And that there is worldly matters that preoccupy a lot of us from doing the salah and fulfilling the salah. Okay? For example, sleeping. It's what makes a lot of people preoccupied. ولذلك حافظ ابن حجر when he came to the explanation of the hadith أَيُّ الْعَبْرِ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ what actually is most beloved to Allah تبارك وتعالى when the Prophet was asked that question and the Prophet said الصلاة على وقتها ثُمَّ أَيُّ قَالَ ثُمَّ بِرُّ الْوَالِدَيْنِ after the prayer it's to be a good towards your mom and your dad حافظ ابن حجر he said إِلَّا أَنَّ الصَّبْرَ عَلَى الْمُحَافَظَةِ عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَأَدَائِهَا فِي أَوْقَاتِهَا وَالْمُحَافَظَةِ على بر الوالدين أمر لازم متكرر دائم لا يصبر على مراقبة أمر الله فيه إلا الصديقون. The only people who are able to safeguard the five daily prayers because it comes back consistently, continuously, every day we have to pray. And the obedience of the parents is consistent, it's not stopping. صح? Because it's an أمر لازم متكرر دائم. Okay? The only people who are able to uphold it are the as-siddiqoon, the truthful ones. The second benefit that we take from the ayah is the importance of giving al-inayatu biman tahtahu min ahlin wa waladin bita'dibim ala al-muhafadati ala hadhi salat wal-inayati biha wa mutaba'atin fi hadha al-amr al-azim. The importance it is يعني, to take care of your children and your family members when it comes to the prayer. And your children, disciplining them, making sure that they pray. Because the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, as the hadith al-Imam Abu Dawud narrated fi sunanihi min hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said, murru awladakum bis salati wa hum abna'u sab'i sinina. Tell the children to pray when they are 7. But you're not going to be very harsh on them. Lakin wadribuhum alayha, discipline them. وَهُمْ أَبْنَاءُ عَشْرٍ when they are 10. وَفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَهُمْ فِي الْمَضَاجِعِ and separate the boys from the girls. Don't let boys sleep with girls and girls sleep with the boys. Separate between them. Al-Imam Abu Dawud narrated this and also Ahmed before him. Al-Hakim al-Naysaburi Al-Albani rahimahullahi authenticated in his Sahih al-Jami'. So this ayah taught us that you first of all have to pray, okay? And also discipline your children. In making sure that they pray the salah. Yani when they're 7, that's very young, right? From the age of 7, the child is commanded to pray. He's encouraged. But when he reaches 10, if he's not praying and he forsakes it, he's disciplined. فإنه يضرب عليها ضرب تأديب وليس ضرب إتلاف. He is disciplined. Okay? And he is يعني the parents have to make sure that he's يعني praying. But if the parent knows that the child is praying, upholding his prayer, فلله الحمد والمنة. الحافظ الإمام ابن القيم رحمه الله he has a kitab called تحفة المودود. تحفته المودود. And this book is very good. It's one of the earliest books in Islam that was written regarding parenting your children. Parenting. Got a guide and a way to take care of your children and things that you should be doing for your children, right? صح أسمع. So look what Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله he said فَمَنْ أَهْمَلَ تَعْلِيمَ وَلَدِهِ مَا يَنْفَعُهُ وَتَرَكَهُ سُدًا فَقَدْ أَسَاءَ إِلَيْهِ غَايَةَ الْإِسَاءَ. Listen to this. He says anyone who abandons and leaves off educating his child, he doesn't. فَمَنْ أَهْمَلَ تَعْلِيمَ وَلَدِهِ his children, he says, I'm not going to educate you guys. And he says, I'm not going to teach you guys what is beneficial to you. By the way, he might say it sometimes, and sometimes he might not even say that, but actions speak louder than words, right? He just doesn't give any concern. وَتَرَكَهُ سُدًا and he leaves the children, يعني سُدًا فَقَدْ أَسَاءَ إِلَيْهِ غَايَةَ الْإِسَاءَ he has wronged these children, and he has been bad to these children, the worst he could possibly be. وَأَكْثَرُ الْأَوْلَادِ The majority of the children, إِنَّمَا جَاءَهُمْ فَسَادُهُمْ مِنْ قِبَلِ الْآبَاءِ وَإِهْمَالِهِمْ لَهُمْ The majority of the children, where did the problem come to them? Why are they corrupt? Why are they evil? It came to them because their fathers have abandoned them. They've left him. وَتَرْكِ تَعْلِيمِهِمْ فَرَائِضَ الدِّينِ وَسُنَنِهِ They left off teaching them the obligatory matters of the religion, they left off teaching them the voluntary acts. فَأَضَاعُوهُمْ صِغَارًا. So they forsake the children when they're young. فَلَمْ يَنْتَفِعُوا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَمْ يَنْفَعُوا آبَاءَهُمْ كِبَارًا. They didn't benefit the children when the children were young. And now that the children are older, the children doesn't want to benefit his parents. So who was bad first? It was the parent who was bad first, who never taught this child what he needed to know. He didn't teach his child the wajibat and the things Allah wants from them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't. And now that the father and the mother are very old in age, they are abandoned by their children. So the qa'idah is, anyone who abandons their obligation when they are young, do not expect the obligation to be fulfilled for you when you are old. فَأَضَاعُوهُمْ صِغَارًا فَلَمْ يَنْتَفِعُوا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَمْ يَنْفَعُوا آبَاءُهُمْ كِبَارًا. They never benefited their children when they were young. They didn't teach them. They didn't discipline them. And now that they are old, your children are not going to benefit you. ولذلك, brothers, I want to say, إِنَّهُ مَقَامٌ جِدٌّ خَطِيرٌ يَتَطَلَّبُ مِنَ الْأَبْ أَنْ يَكُونَ أَوَّلًا نَاصِحًا لِنَفْسِهِ ثُمَّ نَاصِحًا لِمَنْ تَحْتَهُ مِنْ أَهْلٍ وَأَوْلَادٍ. This matter is very important when it comes to the children, my beloved brothers and sisters. As a father, to those fathers who are out there, be a sincere advisor, number one, to yourself. And the second one is, be a sincere advisor to your children. تَعْدِيبًا عَلَى هَذِي الصَّلَاةِ. Discipline them when it comes to these prayers. وَدَعْوَةً لَهُمْ بِالْمُحَافَظَةِ عَلَيْهَا وَالْعِنَايَةِ بِهَا. Teach them how important the prayer is and the salah, and that they should pray it. وَيَا أَيُّهَا الْإِبْنُ الْمُوَفَّقِ. And I now want to talk about to the sons.
What about if the child is young and he doesn't know what religion means and he doesn't even know that it exists and the parent just didn't care about him, and when he grew up he didn't even know that there's a real religion, will he get the dhanb?
If the child was never taught, as here the question she asked was, when the child was young, no one taught him about the religion, no one taught him about the salah, no one taught him about Allah, and now he's grown old. When he was young, he wasn't taught. When he grows older, if there are people who are teaching about Islam in his area, and there's knowledge of Islam around, okay, and he can go and find out, and he chooses not to go, he heard about Islam, he didn't want to learn about it, then he won't be excused. He's a negligent individual. He chose not to learn about it. But if there was no way for him to learn about Islam, there was no one to teach him, he wanted to learn Islam, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. We are not to punish unless we send a messenger to them. What does that mean? Unless the message reaches them. رُسُلًا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنذِرِينَ لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى اللَّهِ حُجَّةٌ بَعْدَ الرُّسُلِ. So that's the answer to that. Now I want to talk to the children who Allah has given them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessing of understanding the religion. Allah has given them the blessing, subhanahu wa ta'ala, of upholding the religion. So I say, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِبْنُ الْمُوَفَّقِ إِذَا أَكْرَمَكَ اللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَى بِأَبٍ يَعْتَرِي بِكَ فِي هَذِهِ الصَّلَاةِ حَثًّا وَحَظًّا وَتَرْغِيبًا. If Allah has blessed you with a father who is taking his time out to teach you the religion, who is taking his time out to encourage you to uphold your religious values, فَإِيَّاكَ ثُمَّ إِيَّاكَ. Stay away from أَنْ تَنْزَجَ مِنْ وَالِدِكَ أو أَنْ تَتَضَجَّرَ مِنْ مُتَابَعَتِهِ لَكَ. Stay away from disregarding the advice that he's given you. And stay away from being disrespectful towards him. فَإِنَّهُ وَاللَّهِ. Because by Allah, he is يَعْمَلُ عَلَىٰ إِنْقَاذِكَ مِنْ سَخَطِ اللَّهِ. He's working towards saving you from the punishment of Allah. وَيَعْمَلُ. He's working hard. عَلَىٰ إِصْلَاحِكَ وَإِيصَالِكَ إِلَىٰ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. He's working towards perfecting your situation and even connecting you to Allah تبارك وتعالى. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ لَا يَرْضَى عَنْكَ إِذَا كُنْتَ مِنْ أَهْلِ هَذِهِ الصَّلَاةِ مُحَافَظَةً عليها وأداء لها. فإن الله جل وعلا الله تبارك وتعالى لا يرضى عنك إلا إذا كنت من أهل هذه الصلاة. Allah will not accept from you unless you are from the people of the prayer. Unless you are from those who protect their prayer and who fulfill their prayer the way that they should. Look at the مقام ثناء الله العاطر على نبيه إسماعيل, the way Allah praised إسماعيل عليه السلام, a great prophet of Allah تبارك وتعالى. What did Allah say? He said about him, وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ وَكَانَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ مَرْضِيًّا. Ismail was one who used to command his family بِالصَّلَاةِ, the prayer. وَالزَّكَاةِ, he used to command his family to give zakat. وَكَانَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ مَرْضِيًّا. And to his Lord, Allah was pleased with him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَانَ مَرْضِيًّا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ لِأَنَّهُ بَذَلَ الْأَسْبَابَ الَّتِي يُنَالُ بِهَا رِضَى اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى. To Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, he was one, he was pleased with him. Why? Because Ismail exerted every effort possible to be from those who Allah is pleased with him. And from the greatest thing is al-inayatu bis-salati hifdhan laha wa muhafadatan 'alayha wa ta'diban lil-ahli wa tarbiyatan lahum 'ala al-muhafadati 'alayha. Al-Imam Malik narrated fi Muwatta'ihi 'an Zayd ibn Aslam 'an abihi anna 'Umar ibn al-Khattab kana yusalli min al-layli ma sha'a Allah. حتى إذا كان من آخر الليل أيقظ أهله للصلاة يقول لهم الصلاة الصلاة ثم يتلو هذه الآية وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك والعاقبة للتقوى. الإمام مالك narrated in his Muwatta that Zayd ibn Aslam, he said from his father that عمر بن الخطاب, he used to pray at night time whatever Allah writ for him. And he would pray a lot. When it's the last portion of the night, أيقظ أهله للصلاة, he would wake up his wife and his children for the prayer. يقول لهم, he will say to them, الصلاة الصلاة. And then he will recite the ayah, وأمر أهلك بالصلاة واصطبر عليها لا نسألك رزقا نحن نرزقك والعاقبة للتقوى. So look at the situation, my brother and my sister. فتأمل حال السلف الصالح رحمهم الله ورضي عنهم. Look at the pious predecessors, how their situation was, how they took on التوجيه الرباني العظيم. ثم تأمل واقع وحال كثير من الناس في تفريطهم وإضاعتهم وعدم تأديبهم لهذا الواجب العظيم. I want to say, we are at a time in our lives as parents that we should be disciplining our children. A lot of us have young kids who are growing up right now. We nurture them on making sure that they safeguard their prayers and that they pray. So when they grow older, when they're in their teens and when they're young adults, they pray. And Ibrahim alayhi salam's dua was what? رَبِّ اجْعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابُ. نسأل الله جل في علاه أن يوفقنا أجمعين للمحافظة على هذه الصلاة وأن يصلح أولادنا وأن يجعلنا وإياهم من المقيمين الصلاة. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.